As I traveled through South Africa over the last week, I visited several great places and also enjoyed a lot the local food. I even had the chance to attend a braai, truly where I got served one of the best steaks ever. I had the opportunity to talk to some of the beef cattle producers that claimed credit for my great steaks, as well as dairy farmers. And both groups are very important for me and the work that I'm doing. What you need to know is I'm a scientist. I dedicated over one decade working on a way to reduce the environmental impact of both dairy cows and beef cattle, the so-called ruminants. And I would like to share a new invention with you. You may ask yourself the question, why am I talking about cows? In my home country, Switzerland, the cow is seen as an iconic symbol of Swiss people, root, tradition, and heritage. And I learned here in South Africa, the cow is a symbol of wealth, and the value is universally recognized in traditions such as Lobola. And as you know, that's where the family of the husband is offering a gift or a dowry, most often cattle, to the family whose daughter is joining the household. And there's a very good reason why cows are so important. Cows and cattle nourish our world. Over 80% of the global population has dairy products in their diets. That's 4 out of 5 people here in the audience. And that's not surprising, because that's one of the most accessible and affordable forms of valuable nutrition. And cows supporting our livelihood. Over 1 billion jobs globally are tied to dairy and beef cattle production. And let's not forget, they convert undigestible feed into valuable proteins for us humans. But there's a big dilemma. These ruminants, cow and cattle, are getting now a bad reputation in some people's mind, mainly because of their environmental footprint, which is predominantly coming from methane. And methane is a strong greenhouse gas and is contributing substantially to climate change and global warming. Let's focus for a moment on this methane. One of the big things that came out of the UN Climate Conference COP26 that took place in November 2021 in Glasgow was the recognition that methane matters. Over 100 countries were signing up to the Global Methane Pledge, setting themselves the target to reduce methane by 30% until 2030. And the UN Climate and Clean Air Coalition even stretched this target and said if we reach 45% until 2040, that's the equivalent of a 0.3 degree avoided heating towards the Paris Climate Agreement target of 1.5 degrees. That's huge. And the recent IPCC report clearly stated that reducing methane emission is our biggest opportunity to slow down global warming and climate change. So what makes methane so specific? First, methane traps much more heat in the atmosphere than CO2. That's expressed in the so-called global warming potential, which is on the 20-year time frame 84 times higher than CO2. This also allows us to mathematically translate methane emissions into CO2 equivalents and making things comparable. And secondly, methane gets destroyed in the atmosphere over 10-year time period, which is much faster than CO2, which stays up there for hundreds of years. Today, we know pretty well where anthropogenic, that means human-caused methane, is coming from. It's basically from three areas. It's energy, it's waste, and it's agriculture. And let's be clear, we need to do something on all three of them. But in agriculture, over 50% of this methane emission is coming from ruminants, and more precisely from the way they digest their feed. This has been known for decades, but there was very little that we could do about it. I would like to share with you a very cool scientific breakthrough that's currently introduced into the markets around the world. We developed a technology to cut this methane emission from ruminants by anywhere between 30 and 90%. Simply by feeding the animal a small amount of a compound that's called 3-NOP. This is now better known by its product name, Bovaer. And such a scientific breakthrough doesn't come overnight. It took us 12 years for the full product development. And when I started over a decade ago, the odds were all stacked against us. But we knew we had to do something. So we asked ourselves, what do we need to do differently? First, we went back to basics. Strictly speaking, it's not the cow that's producing methane, but it's the microorganisms that live within this cow. These microorganisms, they enable the cow to digest the feed and turn it into valuable nutrition for the animal, or eventually for us, humans, that's milk and meat. But by doing so, these microorganisms are producing waste products, that's hydrogen and CO2. And there is a specific set of microorganisms, the so-called archaea or methanogens, that take up this hydrogen and CO2 waste products and convert it through a complex cascade of enzymatic transformation into methane, which is then burped out. An important detail for you to know is 95% of the methane is leaving the animal at the front end. It's burped out, not at the back end. We then took a deep dive into the molecular biology of these methanogens of the archaea. And like for all biological process, this complex cascade of enzymatic transformations can be seen as a series of molecular switches that turn the process up and down. And then we have to decide which of these molecular switches do we want to address. We choose the very last step because this is very specific for these methanogens and doesn't appear anywhere else in the cow. This was also a high precision strategy because in this way we wanted to exclude any unwanted side effects. And next we had to find out, how do we reduce methane? By combining structural biology data and modern computational methods, we started to identify molecules that could interfere or reduce the activity of this very last step of methane formation. In fact, we tested over 5 million compounds in our sophisticated computer model, and that's a process that's called virtual screening. And then in parallel, we had to set up test capacities in the laboratory to see if the molecules that are coming out of our computer model had a real effect in real life and were really able to reduce methane formation from these microorganisms. Overall, that was a process of choosing test substances. We did it with over 1,000 of them, testing them in the laboratory, sorting them out, and narrow them down to a handful of top candidates, and they went to a series of additional testing, and then we moved forward the best one of them, the molecule with the technical name 3NOP. Afterwards, we moved into what turned out the most extensive global testing program for methane-reducing feed additives ever conducted. But we didn't do this on our own. We did this in collaboration with international agricultural research organizations, their researchers, and academics. And we published all our results along the way. Now, in early March 2022, we have achieved 51 scientific peer-reviewed publications, which also means that all our knowledge is easily accessible to the public, to governments, public and private institutes, and academics. And this series of publications also confirms clearly the efficacy of our technology in reducing methane emission from ruminants in various geographies and in various feeding systems. And since we know the mode of action of our active ingredient 3NOP in detail, the beauty is it always works. And that's the type of technology that you want to have, and that's really going to make a difference for the sector, but most importantly for our planet. As of today, we have tested this technology in 15 countries around the world, and we are also proud to communicate that we have already reduced over 2,000 tons of carbon emissions during this extensive testing period. In 2019, we gave the substance an official name and called it Bovaer. And how do you remember it? Bovaer is a combination of two words, it's bovine and air. And it's only a small amount of Bovaer that's making a big difference. In fact, you only need to feed 1 to 1.5 gram of the active ingredient per animal and per day. In more simple terms, a quarter of a teaspoon mixed in the daily feed of the animal will reduce methane emission immediately to the target level, anywhere between 30 and 90%. Within 30 minutes, methane emissions go down, and thereby already reducing greenhouse gas emissions from the agricultural sector and helping our fight against climate change. A methane reduction over 30%, what does it really mean? Well, as a rule of thumb, a dairy cow produces roughly 3 tons of CO2 equivalents as methane per year. And by applying our technology, you can take out 1 ton of this emission out of the equation. It also works for beef cattle. Beef cattle are a little bit smaller. Their emission baseline in methane is a bit less. So we say, as a rule of thumb, we take out 0.5 ton for this species. Another way of looking at it is, feeding this technology bovair to 3 animals is the equivalent of taking a family-sized car off the road. And this emission reduction is significant for any sector. And then also, with the millions of cattle out there, the potential of this technology runs into the reduction of millions of tons of CO2 equivalents. What does it mean for you and me as consumer? Well, let's quickly have a look at the carbon footprint of a liter of milk. 50% of this carbon footprint of a liter of milk is coming from the methane from the cow. And by applying our technology, you can take out up to 20% of this carbon footprint of the liter of milk. And considering that 30% of our individual footprints, yours and mine, is coming from the food we eat, then it's clear that this technology is really key for a more sustainable food production system. And this amount of greenhouse gas emission reduction is relevant for any sector, but most importantly, for our planet. Of all challenges we face, climate change is a real global one affecting us all, and we are all requested to do something about it. In essence, that means reducing greenhouse gas emission at scale, or decarbonization at scale. I showed you that the agricultural sector can be a key player or a key contributor towards this strategy. The story I shared is a story of determination, innovative thinking, and great teamwork to tackle this important issue of methane emission from ruminants. And by making sustainability the central purpose of our innovation, we now can go to work every day and say we truly enable the farmer to make a big difference in our global effort against climate change. Thank you.